Hello. So I just got access to GitHub Copilot. So we are going to try it out in this video. So GitHub Copilot is essentially just a language model, which works in a similar way to like GPT-3 or something. But instead of training it on human language, they trained it on, I think, all or most of the code on GitHub. And so the idea is you start to write code, and then just like a language model would predict words that come after your prompt, Copilot is going to predict code that comes after the code you've already written. So I have it set up here. It just wrote this fib function. I wrote the header, and then it wrote an implementation. So I wanted to try something a little harder though. So we were going to do Busy Beaver. So Busy Beaver is a just kind of like a fun program where you make a Turing machine and then you try to get it to do as long of a terminate, you try to get it to run as long as possible without terminating given a set number of states. So yeah, we'll keep this open as a reference. Okay. So let's do states as numbers. Oh, that's interesting. So we are going to do transition later, but not right now. Self. So we do want that, but not this. Okay. So I guess we want a tape. Def tape. Class tape. Yeah, so definitely good at finishing these. So I guess those are pretty easy. So I'm thinking a tape will just be a list and index. And then the state is going to be okay. And then perfect. Well, okay. So is the... should the tape wrap around? Is a single way... oh, no. Machine uses a single two-way infinite or unbounded tape. Oh, interesting. Two-way infinite unbounded tape. I guess we could just make the values a dictionary with that you can go negative. Dict int. So it's actually not int to state, it's going to be int to int to something in the values, which is int 0 and 1. Alright, so it's gonna get this self.index minus equals 1. Oh yeah, I guess that's easy enough. Okay. Next. Cool. Okay. So simple. Move and state transition to which may be the halt state. Okay, I will say is the halt state. Okay. So, oh, that's funny. Pretty much figured out what we're doing. Transition function, which takes the state. So what's this saying? State. If state dot val equals -1, try. Okay, I don't know what this is doing. Oh, so I guess it's just like some simple transition function. So if it's the halt state, stay the halt state. If it's 0, then move to the right and return. Interesting. Okay, I guess we'll use this as the first transition function. Symbol tried over this correct symbol. Which maybe it's a hot state. So this is doing the transition and moving it. Oh, but not writing over. So we should do it set. I guess let's just see if we can run this first. So let's do the starting state equals state 0. Tape equals tape. What are they coming up with? 0, 0, 1, 0. That's a reasonable take. Okay. And then while nailed it. State dot alt is false. State equals transition function. State trait. Wow, I'm very impressed. I was expecting this to be a lot worse. Okay, so while state dot alt is false, yep, state equals transition function. Okay. Print state. Oh, so it ran twice, and then we're just like overflowing something. Okay, nice. Exactly what I was doing. converted in? Oh, yeah. Okay, so we start with state 0, and okay, so we start with state 0 and the tape at 0, which is 0, and then we transition state tape. Okay. We can actually update this time. If state dot halt. Okay, if state dot halt return state -1. Tape dot get 0, which is what we, so this is what happens. It moves right and returns a state of 1. Which is what we see here. And then we go again, tape.get. So now we're going to pull the second 0 and move to 2. And then we overflow. Okay. So we have a working Turing machine. May take a break for now, though. I was pretty impressed. It had pretty good recommendations. It clearly figured out that we were trying to make a Turing machine, and came up with good recommendations based on that. I think the most impressive thing was this transition function. It essentially just wrote this based on, and I think largely or totally fitted with the classes we'd already created. So yeah, I'm impressed. Okay, I'm back. So we're working on Busy Beaver with GitHub Copilot. So one thing I was thinking is to make this transition make this transition function a little easier to use. Sorry, Copilot. So let's make this a just match this more explicitly. So transition function takes two inputs, a state, and state and a tape. So it takes the symbol in the current tape cell and so Oh, wait, no. I did that wrong. Okay, so it takes the symbol of current non-halt state. And then symbol and is it a 0 or 1? Okay, and so it's going to return a tuple of a symbol direction and a state to transition. New state. I guess this isn't right, but we'll leave it for now. Okay. So we need a more clear symbol. So this can help me with, I forget exactly how to do the enum class direction. I need to import it. Okay. If direction equals beautiful. Okay. So the direction is a, so the symbol is an int, the direction is a and new state. So let's do this basic, the simplest one, which is the two state. Okay. So state 0 state 0 We can make zero the alt state, because I think that's what this seemed to be the convention. Okay, so it's going to start at 1, and then so the state should start at 1. Okay. So so we could add the limit. Or I guess if we just only use certain states, then okay. So we'll start at state 1 with 2 zeros on the I guess the tape is infinite. Okay. So we can use a default tick. Okay. Okay, so starting at state 1 with an infinite zeroed out tape at position 0. Okay. While state.halt equals false, so symbol direction new state equals state and then tape dot get which is a symbol. Perfect. And we also want a way to print this. Def state, we want to see the we can just do that here. Okay, print state tape Perfect. Okay. So let's just write an infinite looping one. So if state if state dot we actually have to do it then. So state dot move direction. First we have to write. Set perfect. State dot move direction. Okay, first state dot write. State dot write. Oops. Let's see if it gets it then. Tape dot write. Yep. Tape dot write symbol, state dot move direction. Oh, it should be tape dot move. Tape dot move direction, and then state equals new state. Okay. State. State one. Tape. State val is so it seems like state shouldn't be an int, it should be a state object. The state object gets passed here. And then I'm trying to get the val. Int object is not good. Oh. It's value. Okay. Cannot. Oh, direction return. Wait, no. Cannot. Unpack non-iterable none type. Oh, so this. Okay, I guess we didn't really examine this. Okay, so the transition value is if it's. State value. Okay, anyways, this just doesn't matter anymore. Okay, so if we're assuming it's not state.hold, state.value equals one, and symbol equals 0. State value. No, that's not right. One and symbol equals one. Okay, so we have states 1 and 2, and then 0 is the halting state, and symbols 0 or 1, and we essentially have this table. So let's do a just going back and forth between the states, just see it go. So, if it's at 1, it's always going to go to, two, and if it's at 2, it's always going to go to 1. This is not going to be a busy beaver, this is just going to loop. Alright, regardless of the symbol, and we're just gonna go to the left a bunch and write ones all along the way. Okay. Let's see what this says. Type. Type object has no attribute. There we go. Well, so we got to tape negative 1,740, writing lots of ones. Okay. So now we can try a real busy beaver. Okay. So we have. Okay, so we have states. halt, 1, 2, and we're gonna okay. So you want to write as many ones as possible. Okay, let's just do a super simple one to start. So we'll just start at 1, write a 1, go to 2, write another 1, and then halt. Okay. So state.value is 1. So we're going to go to, we want to write a 1, always writing 1s. Let's go to the right. Okay. I'm gonna write a 1 and then go to state 2. And then if it's state 2, I'm gonna write a 1 and halt. Okay, so we start, boot right at 1, move to the right, go to state 2, state 2, we can see our old 1, transitioning, go to, wait, that's wrong, state is 2, we should go to, oh, new state 0, yeah, right at 1. State 0. That's weird, why didn't it halt? Oh, oops. Print halted. And then okay, so we wrote 2 ones. Okay. And so the actual Busy Beaver score is the number of ones. Okay, so let's get a so score equals sum tape dot values. Yep. Score 2. All right. Whew. So, I guess let's see if it can come up with some good Busy Beaver solutions. So basic Busy Beaver. Okay. Def transition. Date. Single. Okay. Okay, so, moment of truth. Def advanced busy beaver state simple. All right, so what did it come up with? 1-1 with the exact same. No, this is different. Let's see how well it scored. Score 2. Okay. Oh wait, we didn't actually run it. And busy beaver. Score 2. Okay. So we start at state 1. We write a 1. We move to the right. Then we're at state 2. State 2, we move to the. So we have our old one, we move to the left, which is different than what I did. And. Then it's halt. Okay, so it did the same thing as me, except we had a left and a right, which I guess is more advanced than mine. Mine only moved to the right. wait, state.value equals 1. Oh, interesting. It also did this differently, but it still works. Either way. Okay, so let's try busy beaver 3. This just seems a little boring. Or I wonder, what's the... best to see motion. Maybe we could get it to like go to the right one, write a one, go to one end and then go back to the other and then stop. Yeah, let's try that. Okay, so we'll start at 1, then move to the right. Yeah. And move to 2, otherwise we'll just loop forever. Okay. Come back to that. And then we're at 2. I'm gonna write a 1, go to the left, and go back to, we could just stay at 2. Let's hit 2, and then hit the other side. Yeah. And then we're going to go to the left. And Okay, and then when we hit the left side. Wait. So we're going to start with the tape that looks like this, and then we're going to go to write a 1, and then be here at, with a state 2, and then we want to write a 1, and then go back to the left. Oh, we can use the 1 state to go back. So, state.value 2 equals... and then for the 1s, if it's already seeing 1, it'll just keep going to the left. Stay 1. And then write a 1. Okay, so we're going to be state 1. We state 1. We're going to write a 1 and move to the right. Be in state 2. We're going to be in state 2. We're going to write a 1. Move to the left. And go to state 1. State 1 is going to see the 1. Go to the left. Go to the left. So we're in state 1 now. On a 0. Okay. And then we're going to write a 1. Write a 1. And then, since it's... We're going to write a 1. Let's do this again. Okay, so we're going to be at the beginning in state 1. We're going to then hit this first one, move to the right, we're going to write a 1 and move to the right. Okay, so we're going to be here. We're going to write a 1 and move to the right. And then okay. So we're here, write a 1, move to the right. Write a 1, move to the right, go to state 2. And then in state 2, we're going to see the 0, write a 1, move to the left, and then we're in state 1 now, so state 1, with the symbol 1, we move to the left, writing a 1, but over it, staying in state 1, and staying in state 1, okay, and then we're here, so now we're state 1. Move to the left again. Okay. So we're here, and then we move to the state 1. Read a 1, move to the left, overwrite the 1, move to the left. So now, and we're staying in state 1. So now state 1 value equals 1. No, so, yeah. So now we're here. So we're going to write a 1. Write a 1 and set the state to 2 and move to the right. And now state. So now we're going to be in state 2, symbol 1, which is, yeah, this is the last one. State 0. Okay. I think this may work. Score 3. Oh, perfect. Wow. Alright, I think that's a good place to stop.